What's up, guys? Welcome to ParadiZe. This episode's gonna be a bit different. My microphone did not record a damn thing. Not a single blip of noise. So I'm gonna do my best just to brief you on what's happening. For example, right now, we're talking about the rocket door and how I was an idiot standing next to it once, walking past it once, and then an hour later, finding it. Stupid. Dumb. I could have just used my fucking eyeballs. Now we're talking about the weapon that I want that I can't use yet because I'm only level 35. Crafted anyway. Then I go through the inventory, make sure everything is good because we're about to head out and talk to Alfred to turn in some twinkles and then head to the warehouses to search for Bob.
Thank you. Thank you much. Twinkle! I'm sorry. When I don't have my twinkles, I become quite a different person. I'm indebted to you, kind sir. I look forward to making your acquaintance again soon.
This is where the audio was all jacked up. Something changed. I'm not entirely sure what happened. My microphone stopped working and the sound on the game got weird. So I'm dicking around with that. And now we're gonna go find Bob. Oh, after I do the skills. Which I think I put them in the Zombots. HP. So over here, I find these landmines, or they're not landmines, I don't know if they are sea mines or ocean mines or whatever the hell you want to call them. They shock you. They kind of sort of make your weapon go wonky. And we find another story.
Bob's Archives P-63-5, the Fan Shredder Zombot. Open the portable pylon configuration menu. Equip your Zombot with a shredder and a chainsaw. Then order it to use these to provoke enemies while in combat. And there you have it, a Zombot that lures its enemies in to more effectively shred them like a deadly cyclone. Ha ha ha!
And then I talk about how we need to start doing stuff with the Zombots. Souping them up, giving them blades or a saw, chainsaw, whatnot. And now this is where Ivy comes into play.
Hey, what are you doing here? Yes, that's me, Ivy UPPERSMITH, obviously. Who did you think you'd find? Santa Claus? What do you want? Free Bob? Don't make me laugh. And just why would I want to free such a useful lab rat? As if asking nicely is enough. Enough! I've wasted enough time as it is, and I won't tolerate your presence here any longer. Clear off! My genius is needed elsewhere.
This is where we have to kill a bunch of zombies, because, you know, why wouldn't we? And I finally realize at this point that I cannot capture any of these. Oh, I can capture one. There was a point where I couldn't capture anything. And that gas will one-shot you. So your Zombots will clear out that gas. This is where I'm looking for the shredder, which comes into play a little later. And there it is. I find it and equip it. That's where I find out the gas one-shots you. There's no turning back from that. Don't go in the gas. Finally make it out of that warehouse, which was awful because you can't see anything. Then I realize I have the wrong gun equipped, so I gotta equip the other gun to where I can actually start doing something worthwhile. I then send Pete in there to clear the gas. That's the only way to get past the gas. And it continues on like this for quite a while. Probably 40 minutes of getting lost and traversing these pathways. This is where I find out that those mines are not good. I send Pete in there to clear the gas. We finally make it to the chemical plant's control room, which I then get confused because I can't activate any of these buttons. So I go down, I clear all the zombies down there, I clear that pylon. And this is where I realized that I have three other objectives. I have to turn on the first, second, and third light, which is spread throughout the map that we just walked through. This is where I find the secondary control platform. Turn that on and then proceed to get lost. Actually, I think it counted as the first, but proceed to get lost for 20 minutes before finding another one. So this is me finding the third one, which is on the second story. Actually, I think they were all in the second story. Oh no, the second one's on the third story, which is all the way up on the top right-hand side. I found it, and now I'm heading back to the warehouse to search for Bob. We made it back to the warehouse with the buttons, and when you activate these buttons, it moves that little bridge so you can continue down the path. None of these buttons operate anything. Well, that one doesn't. This one does. I have to push the button anyway, for whatever reason. And we go up the stairs and find Bob.
Quick! Ivy wants to hack all our pylons and turn them against us. We must stop her!
Stop me? What nonsense! You're so stupid, you'd challenge a mirror to a staring contest. You're not going anywhere with my servant.
This is where we have to escort Bob out of harm's way. Which hasn't... It wasn't all that bad. And Ivy puts in her 2 cents.
You'd rather flee than be associated with my masterwork? Hardly surprising. You'd lose at tic-tac-toe against a zombie. Oh, no witty comeback? Luckily for you, I'm not so cruel as to take away your right to hide in silence. People like you disgust me. We all know what to expect from you, but somehow you still manage to disappoint. Some people have grand plans in life, while others are content to merely survive. And you're going to fail even at that. I'll see you at your camp.
We must stop Ivy. Try to lure her to your camp. Barricade yourself in and destroy her vehicle. I'll go hide with Mac and Ignacio. Hey! Good luck!
And this is where we head back to camp, reorganize, and it's also when I realized that my microphone didn't record a goddamn thing. My PC was not registering my microphone at all, as if it wasn't even plugged in. I did manage to fix it, which is why you're hearing me now. So this episode's a little bit wonky. It's not ideal, and I apologize thoroughly. I am sorry. The technical difficulties get the better of me, but I'm slowly trying to figure all this shit out. Anyway, I want to thank you guys for joining me. I deeply do apologize. I love all the support. Thank you guys for joining me. You guys are awesome. This is Wobble Pop Gaming, and I will see you in the next one.